up, my YouTube friends? Keith Marrow here. Welcome to episode 3 of Down to the Marrow. Today we're out here cruising around in a golf cart in the neighborhood, playing metal guitar, doing all the important work. I'm kind of like the ice cream man, except I'm playing notes and everyone's running away from me. But I got everything you need, man. I got these ice cold DVDs right here on sale at keithmarrow.com. I got these awesome towels right here for waxing your car in the driveway in the summer sun. And the most delicious thing I have on the menu are these tab books available at my sponsor for this video, SheetHappensPublishing.com. Sheet Happens has all of the artist approved album transcriptions from all of your favorite artists. Look at this goof right here. These are high quality books, but you also get it in a digital format for you guys who can't read books. Right now we're about to crack open this book and play a song for my entire neighborhood. Ready, Ethan? Let's go. So recently, the ultimate Swede, Ola England, and myself have been bouncing questions back and forth to each other for our Q&A videos. Let's see what he's got for us this week.
I'm gonna ask you a question, Keith, because now that you're back, we want to see you continue pump out that content. So let's just keep this going, man. I'll ask you a question, maybe you'll ask me one more time. Who knows? Okay, I have a question for you. I know you're using the Kemper when you're out doing clinics and all that. How does it compare to the XFX, in your opinion? What makes it better than the XFX?
Thank you, Ola. I think the main reason why I still use the Kemper is basically just because it does everything I need it to do, and it does it pretty well. What I like about the Kemper is that I can basically store snapshots of any amp rig that I engineer in this room and that I use on records, and then I can go and take those tones out with me and perform or do mobile recording. And they're unique tones. They're tones that I created here in the studio with actual rigs that I own. But I honestly wouldn't say that the Kemper is better or worse than the AxeFX in any particular way. They're both a really great way of arriving at a good result. I had the original AxeFX back in the day and even used it on a couple albums, and I thought it sounded great. But then the Kemper came along, and so rather than just tweaking the models that they provided you, now you're able to make your own. And that was just really fun to me. My question for you this week, Mr. Ola, is now that you've sort of settled into your new studio and you got things kind of set up the way you want it, do you have any plans for any big upgrades, any studio upgrades? I know you recently did a Mac Pro, which is awesome. And I'm not talking about like the guitars and the gear that you demo in your videos. I'm talking about the production side of it. I know that you get nerdy with cameras and lighting and everything that goes into creating videos like this. I'm wondering, do you have any plans for upgrades in that department, or do you feel like you're at a pretty good spot with it? What are you currently using? That's my question for you this week, my friend. Let me know. So this next question comes from Dad Metal for Life. I love this guy already. He asks, you work a lot with disharmonic, possibly open, dark sounding chords. As someone who's been looking for information on how to attain these sounds, are you able to go any deeper on the theory or possibly different variations of those dark sounding disharmonic chords? So to me, basically what you're talking about is using dissonance as an effect. I don't look at what I'm doing as any particular chord, as in I don't put a name on it. I can't put a name on it. It's just a sound and a shape to me, and a color in a lot of ways. I have a song called Desolate Horizons. It's the first song off of my newest solo album. At the very end of that song, there's a simple progression, and these are the notes that outline that progression. Those are the notes you're listening for, okay? All I'm doing is I'm transposing those notes, and I'm substituting open strings where I can. And that's creating that rub, that's creating the dissonance that I think you're referring to. basically, you can challenge yourself. You can take four or five different notes, write a riff somewhere on the lower register, transpose those notes somewhere where you could hold down the notes or substitute open strings, and play them all at the same time. Let them rub together and create that big cavernous sound that I believe you're referring to. So give that a try, man. Have fun. All right, so this next question comes from Carl on YouTube, and he asks, would it be possible to get Kyle Rasmussen on an episode? Nerd out on gear, talk inspiration and share interests? To me, Vitriol and him are the first band in a long time that have brought death metal to a new and evolved stage. All right, Kyle, so let's just get serious for a sec. I know we've been having a great time joking around. But I gotta hit you with a really hard-hitting question that's been affecting us all lately in the music industry. And it's on a scale of 1 to 10, what do you think of that chair that you're sitting in right now? I don't mean metaphorically speaking, like what do you think about sitting in this chair right now with me?
Yeah.
The actual manifestation of matter that is this chair. I want to know what your thoughts are on this chair.
I would rather open mouth kiss a pigeon than sit in this chair.
What about avian flu? You worried about that at all?
No.
Do you think pigeons need masks?
You know, we all understand the importance of human beings wearing the mask. But today I want to plead to you, Is it always just a mask? Like, can I?
Have you ever seen The Mask? All right, Kyle, so you have your choice of any rig in this facility. What do you choose?
I'm drunk with power.
Well, what do we got? We have, is this a first gen Powerball? Let's go for consistency.
Okay.
And we'll go with the Bogner Ubershaw.
Ooh.
A boost is very necessary for my tone.
All
right. Bogner, Rev, 805.
Tell Carl why you've chose this rig.
Well, Carl, I'm so glad you asked. I have one at home, and I know how to use it.
Bored.
And it's
so you're lazy and you went with the most convenient option?
Yes. You know when you go to Chuck E. Cheese and the animatronic band is playing? I want that dude's rig.
We really went full Barry Richard, just buried the D in this interview, didn't we?
Yeah. On this episode of Sick Riff Worship, I decided to go with a riff that wears its influences really strongly on its sleeve. I like what Keith did the other day with his Morbid Angel video, and he and I have been talking a lot about our early influences, our formative experiences with death metal, and for me, a big one won't come as a surprise to my fans or people that engage with my music is Eric Rutan and his work in Hate Eternal specifically. So this song, Legacy of Contempt, was really trying to get to the essence of what I liked about his chaotic and dissonant creative voice and try to make it my own. So here you go.
Both have found ourselves with new and unexpected downtime due to the current state of the world.
Yes.
And the pandemic and the COVID situation and pigeons without masks.
Yes, it is it's really the pigeons.
I see people who are woke as fuck do this all the time.
I think it's getting your chi back to your mouth.
Okay. What I'm really trying to do right now is I'm trying to summon Sophia.
Okay, we can get
I felt the overwhelming power of your wokeness. It just drew me.
So, Steel Weather, why don't you tell me a little bit about what you have going on with that project. Your primary focus is guitar straps at the moment, it seems, but you're also working on other things. Why don't you tell me a little bit about what you're working on?
Came together as an idea of being so restricted, not being able to go out there and play the music, but still wanting to be able to contribute to the community and the culture in the same way, like speak to the same demographic that Vitriol is speaking to. For those of you who saw Vitriol on our first handful of tours, I was using a pretty chunky Spike guitar strap. I had a lot of people asking me where to get one, and lo and behold, there is no place to get one until now. Enter Steel Weather. This is our little, we'll do a little unboxing for you. The packaging is meant to let you feel the frustration we feel making the product.
Yeah.
Before you even see what we have made for you. This is the face of Steel Weather, right? This is our attempt at making the most spiked strap we could come up with. This has almost 200 handset spikes. All this stuff is handmade. Keith was kind enough to come out and actually do a really in-depth filming of the process. So we'll be able to have that on full display. But we wanted to make just the most full-on, uncompromising guitar strap. Extremely comfortable strap. It's 3 inches wide, hand tufted quad pad with leather rivets. And so, you know, beyond Steel Weather being a strap company, our dedication and devotion to a community of people and how broad we believe that community to be. And a lot of the music that I listen to, whether it be hardcore, death metal, black metal, street rap, you know, to me, the spirit of that music is universal. These different genres of music are using a lot of the same energy, a lot of the same fuel to create that art. It's a way to have fun, you know what I mean? And like that is hard for a lot of us. It's also apparel that we're gonna be doing.
Right.
And it's not, you know, we're not just doing slapping a logo on a shirt, you know, we're reaching out to artists within the underground, within, you know, the metal community, the hardcore community.
That are contributing to it.
Yeah, yes. And that we're reaching out to them and getting inspired designs.
So where can I get one of these? I need one.
You can find us at steelweatherdesigns.com.
Steelweather on Instagram.
All right, my friends, that's it for this week. Don't forget to leave your question in the comment section of this video, and it might show up in the next Down to the Marrow. Hey, you guys like this killer dragon bell thing I got when I was in Taipei? Apparently, it'll bestow upon you ancient wisdom when you like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Nothing happened. This thing sucks.